Yes, good afternoon again. In terms of, and I guess we'll speak just generally about arts and culture, in terms of entrepreneurship from a business model perspective. And there are different ways that we can conceive the artist as a business model. Now there's the individual as the artist themselves, and then there is an actual business that is based on the arts. Now, I'm going to talk more about entrepreneurship from the perspective of a business based on the arts. Now, firstly, we conceive and we say, okay, there's a lot of talk about the creative and cultural industries. And we keep seeing a lot of successes happening abroad. And why we can't bust too? You know, so that question comes up quite a bit. Now, for the artist model, and you know, there's always a saying, start a yard before you go abroad, you know. But how do we conceptualize and support arts within our country? You know, often it's conceived more as a leisure or something of a hobby rather than a business in and of itself. So even the support for the artists here in terms of paying the artists, you know, a lot of persons want you to come and appear at their events and they'll either ask you to do it for free. And I'm talking especially for dance. Dance more so than a lot of the other art forms. They ask you to do it for free or, you know, for something small. Value. How do you value the input that goes into making a product, a piece of choreography? Persons don't know that it actually takes like an hour to choreograph 1 minute. So, you know, in terms of the time invested in that, and then if there is the thought of the quality and standard that you have, because from my perspective, it is also being performing at a global standard. Now, I know we said a lot about regional, but it's beyond that, it's a global standard. With the new technologies that are out there, that's where our competition lies. Now, if that value is not created here, then trying to create a business based on the arts becomes difficult because there's the buying into, yes, I actually should pay for something like this, or that I do want to pay for something like this. There's also a number of the other things that, you know, that were spoken of today as well, the knowledge. So the knowledge of things like copyright issues. So how do you copyright something that is out there in the general public? How do you copyright a step? How do you copyright something that you have created as an artist? And so how then do you put that within a business model? So issues such as copyright become quite pertinent. Funding, you know, or the panel before that spoke about raising capital, it's so true. If you have a business model and it's viable and you can show how you can get profits, yes, that is true. But you do have to step out the hurdle of, well, it's an arts model. You know, it's different. It's a different take than if you were coming with something that was based in IT. And I don't want to bring up my little sore point of STEM, where I hear they're trying to put the A in to say STEAM, but I'll just put it out there. So, you know, it's that take on all these little perspectives. It's also being able to create the kind of partnerships that you need in order to make a business like that successful. So, did Mr. JC leave? Okay. All right, Mr. JC. So whereas you may be able to come to, and there are different kind of networking sessions that you become a part of, but then understandably, artists and business persons may not necessarily network within the same environment all the time. And so where is your opportunity to get into a networking session where you can form those kinds of collaborations and collaborations that you are, the credibility of you as well as the business is able to strengthen your ability to attract other, whether investors or partners into your model. I'm sure there's more that we can discuss further on, but those are some of the basic challenges. So I would say opportunities for partnerships, opportunities for funding, opportunities for copyright licenses and understanding that. And then the issue of copywriting as well becomes so large because it's not just copywriting within your country or within your region, but it's also within the market that you are trying to go into. There is understanding the concept of travel, visas, travel visas, work visas for artists, and all of those little things, that hoops that you have to jump over. The other element that I will discuss is also the great potential for exploitation. And not just talking from my perspective, but even other artists that I know and that are trying to do themselves as a business and startup, it's how do you understand the contracts? How do you understand your rights? How do you understand all these little elements so that you are not exploited? If, for example, we have an agreement on a movie, setting our film, and then the hours go over a certain time, how am I protected in terms of getting my rights where that's concerned? You have places that will pay you for performances and not a choreography fee. So, you know, it just becomes a great discussion about understanding all the different elements and values that come in towards making a business.